Hello, this is already episode 3 in the proof of concept about getting data from crypto exchanges. Last time I told you that I was inspired by this article Battle of the Bots, and I wondered myself, how easy would it be to get some data? Well, at this stage we are in this far. We are able to connect to a given exchange, one exchange, one currency pair. We're able is a backend Docker, talks via Kafka, Docker frontend, and talk to a web browser. And this time we will focus on getting this into automatic building street. So they are capable of validating the code, building the Docker image automatically. So we have a very good starting point for the following steps. How this will be done? This will be done as follows. We have GitHub, where the code is stored, and you probably already have found it. The next step is that we can check the code into Cloud Lab, Sonar Cloud. This is a cloud service to validate Java code, and we make a connection to the Docker web. So, what we will do. GitHub is not only store code, but it can also create a build pipeline. So in this pipeline, we will make a check to SonarCube and we push the code to Docker Hub. We will do it as follows. We will it depends on which Git branch we are working. When it is in develop, we will push the code to Sonar Cloud and do all kinds of validations. We will come back later. And when there is the master branch, it's intended for public use, then we push the code as a Docker image to the Docker Hub. Okay, what we will do in this, we have the code and we are in the development branch. So we create a new branch, feature, call it part 3, and we will make there the modifications to make this possible. And to make this possible, we go to our GitHub, and we see the code is there. We are in the main branch, and this is the important part: actions. We can create a new workflow, and these workflow are triggered when I push the code. That's the whole idea. And when the code is pushed, then I will decide to validate the code to Sonar Cloud or build images and push them to Docker Hub. So this is how it works. We are able to choose a workflow, for instance, this one. And there you already see it, how it works. You give it a name. You see, they tell when the code must be activated and what activation means. In this case, do a checkout out of Git, set up the Java environment and build it. That is what we want to do. So we push this code to the main branch, because that's the easiest way to do it. And so what we will do is we merge this into the current one. Then we see this feature. I called it feature. And there we are able to do, well, this is only a template, and we make a next step. What we also can do is use caching, because every time I do a Maven build, it will be created in a total new environment. So all the files used from the internet, from packages, will be reused again. And caching solves that. That is explained in here. But we can also find it in here. There it explains what to do. And also Maven, Java Maven is part of it. So this is what we want. Node VM, this is what we need. Action 2. Okay, so I make the copy. Say, we will use this name picture, like intended in the part 3. And we do it always, except for the develop and the master branch. And what we will do, I thought there's a room for a name. Name, build, test, the build and test. It runs on the latest Ubuntu version. We do a checkout. Yes, we set up Java 11, and we can copy, where was it, this, to this, and we run Maven as shown, where was it, here, this, build with Maven, okay. Now, let's have a look if it works that way. We have a pipeline, commit and push. Yes, push. Now the steps, because it works for follow, you define the job. What is the starting point and which actions, steps in the action naming of GitHub should be done. And the indentation is important. So we do it once again. Now it is being created, built and test, and now it starts the workflow. This is the first time this process is being run, so it starts downloading all kinds of stuff, as you can see. And the idea is that it should be built, in fact, validate if the code can be compiled. You see a lot of downloading, and this caching local Maven repository is to prevent that we have to do that all the time, every build. So this will be done initially, then it will be stored on a given key, and it will be used only if the POM is not being changed. And it's already doing the post thing, so it was successful, and this green mark also shows. So what we have done now is the first step. Every feature will be built, and I will get an email if there are problems. So the next step is that we say, well, we do something identical. New file, and we call it build. Yes, I want to edit. New workflow. And now I will inspire myself to publish the code to SolarCloud. So, just to get this one here. This is in fact what I want to see. So, build and check. So, every time the code is being pushed to develop, I will do checkout, setup and build, but I have to check what needs to be done to run it in SolarCloud. And SolarCloud is this project. Already we have been created, made a connection between GitHub and SolarCloud. So the project is already there. However, as you can see, nothing is being done in here. So the trick is what to do to make this run. I've done it in a previous project, so I will copy that. So the main trick is this. Oh, this. Then I will modify it. This is not needed. So I will say I do a verify. That's fine. But I want to do a sonar because for the sonar build or the sonar cloud, I need to set some properties and I have to add coverage to it. Of course, I also need a login. Just then Sonar Cloud knows who is logging in. So this is a special trick. And Sonar Cloud also want to retrieve a certain branch from GitHub. And therefore, this information is needed. But first, we focus on this coverage part and the Sonar part. Well, for Sonar, I have prepared it because once you know it, how to be done, you will use it. I put it in a particular profile. It says, well, if the Sonar environment is being used, if the Sonar environment is used, then where do we have to find this Sonar? And what organization, that kind of stuff has been added? And when I say Sonar, what should be done? Well, in this case, I say, well, Maven and the Sonar goal should be processed. To make sure that these that Maven knows which version is being used, I have to add things. Because the whole idea is, I just refer here, similar to the other projects, but first we have to, as a kind of management thing, add them to the build. So here we say, if I refer to Sonar, I mean, no, we put them in a variable. Here it is. And same for, and we use these two, this one and this one for the, in fact, when we run the test, we want to measure coverage. And that is also done by Sonar Cloud. Now here are the version numbers, which will be used in here. So therefore, Maven knows when I refer to this plugin, this one is being used. Sonar is being used, but for the, that is how to access the Sonar environment, but Sonar itself also want to do coverage. Therefore, I introduced another profile. I do it via profiles. So in the normal building phase, we don't need those plugins and so on. So it's only being activated under certain conditions. And these conditions are when I want to activate them. Well, first we commit it. Use pipeline for the develop branch. There is however a problem that I can't test it. And the reason is I'm at this moment acting on the feature branch. And that's not the development branch. And you could say, then make this change. However, there is a limitation in Sonar Cloud. Sonar Cloud is only capable of handling one branch. So I have to decide which branch that is. I've already told Sonar Cloud, use work on the development branch. And well, it can only be one. So what I better can do is, in assumption, of course, that it is running correctly. We can have a check. It's still running. So the best thing now to do is, okay, we move this code to the development branch. And if it is working, then we can validate that this is running. And after that, we will add the Docker build part in the main branch. So normally you work on a particular branch, part 3 in this case, but only for this we have to make a modification to that. Build and test, it's running because that was the name. Sonar Cloud Validation, that's probably a better name. Okay. Once again, I don't think that makes a huge of a change in the difference. So now we go to the development branch. We do checkout. And we merge all the changes of part 3 into the current one. So we would expect that yes, that this workflow is here. So now we are focusing on this one. Well, of course we have to check if this is working, very likely, but we have to make sure that this is working. So what to do? My account, security. I have to create, I can revoke my previous one, I have to generate GitLab a token so that SonarCloud accepts the login from the GitHub, and at the GitHub side I have to introduce this token. Well, there is a specific mechanism for it, and that's called secrets. And that's a particular part of GitHub, that even if you clone the environment, you don't get the secrets. So I created a Sonar token. Bye. I can remove it, because this was from a previous run. New repository secret. I call it Sonar token. And this information is being copied to it. And now, within this action, it knows how to log in to SonarCube. And SonarCube needs information from GitHub, and this is a standard token, so I don't have to recreate it. Probably have to merge first the code. Now it's running on the development branch. The previous one was running correct. As we could see in here, this one was running fine on this feature branch, the previous one, and now the code is running on the development branch. Well, of course, this has been changed. It's the in the development branch, it's the first time, so it will download a lot of stuff. And now it's sending the stuff, preparing and sending the stuff to SonarCloud. But it's still busy, as you can see in here. And after that, we would expect that my project, that something is happening in here. That's the whole idea of this exercise. Okay, we are back. Well, now we see that the code is being pushed and that it was successful, green. And now we can have a look how well the code is. It says, well, the coverage is pretty bad. It's obvious because I don't have any unit tests. So from now on, I will be triggered to add unit tests to improve this coverage. And it says that there is one thing it doesn't like. Okay, this one. So from now on, I get this a code analysis. This form, I can easily replace it. I will do. This one. So now SonarCloud is probably happy as well. Okay, so I will push. Then we also can check SonarCloud analysis results. Then push. It will be sent to the Git, like it shown here. Git, this one. And then SonarCloud every time we push something on the develop, it will be sent to Sonar Cloud so we can have a look what is going on there and how well the code is and so on and so on. Okay, now the next step is to build the Docker images and send the Docker images to the Docker Hub. That's the next step. And we told ourselves we will do this when the code is in the main branch. So, what we will do, if this is working fine, we better have to wait if this all is working fine. But then we send the code to the main branch. So, we check this one out. And all the changes from develop are being merged into this current one. And now we will make the workflow for pushing the data, pushing the Docker images to the Docker Hub. For this, I created a Docker Hub. I created my own environment, but it is obviously empty because it's not I haven't been pushing any images to the Docker. Make a copy. Paste. Publish. Add. Well, we do something similar, but a good copy. Do a different one. Feature is publish images to Docker Hub master branch on the main. Oh, I called it main. Well, okay. For historical reasons, may. Fine with me. This is the same, so only this one is different. And, well, this publish, same in here, so this is what we want to have to do. We build it, we log in, and we publish the stuff. And we do something similar. Docker, this is not what we need. This is what we need. This is not what we need. This is the same. And the images are image backend. The repo, where does this parameter come from? It's an environment parameter as well. Okay, so this is the same. This is in fact already what we have done manually, but now the changes are that we are logging in to the Docker, so we have to add these two secrets and to have to add the secret where the Docker repo is living. And after that, we publish the build images to Docker. Okay, so what we have to do. So, settings, secret, Docker repo, And what's the name of the Docker repo? That is this one, my profile. Not this one, yeah. So this is the name of where the repo is living, that secret. And like I said, the advantage is that when you clone this GitHub, that you don't get the secret information. So in fact, you could also say it's an advantage because it's you are enforced to use your own Docker repo. And now we are using the public one, Docker Hub, but it can be any Docker repository. Okay, so now we have to add the Docker username. This is another application. This is what is look publish. Okay, so we give it a try. Publish Docker images to Docker Hub. Yes, I push them all because also changes from the I merge the develop branch to the main. So all these changes are pushed, and this is this change. This file is pushed as well. So now we have a look at actions, and here it is run. Okay, so it's now logging is successful, publishing is successful, and now it's pushed the image to GitHub, which is in fact what we want. We can have a quick look. Here it is. That's not what I want. Backend. Exactly what I want. And now the frontend is being pushed. And now it's successful. And I would expect that. Yeah, so the frontend and the backend, as you can see, are very generic names. So we, in our image name, we probably have to put something with exchange. But that's something we can do add later. What we wanted to do, this was the application we're building. We are capable now of building and pushing the data to Sona Cloud and have an analysis. What did we want? GitHub pushed the code to Sona Cloud for analysis of the Java code, which is working now. The GitHub is also building Docker images and pushing it to a public repository, Docker Hub, and it would mean that we now have not only the Docker images local on our environment, but also using public services. And now we are ready for the next step, and that will be in part 4. Have a nice day.